Hi there, Dr. Graham here, and I'm joined by
Dr. Marie.
And welcome to Movement Practice Level 2. So this is building on Level 1 when we're still incorporating full body mobility with some more advanced movement patterns. You're also going to find that the stability portion is also a little more advanced and a little tougher. If at any time when you're going through these you're finding particular things too challenging or difficult, you can always ask either one of us, or you can shift back into Level 1 so you build yourself back up. See you soon. We're starting here with cervical 2x2s, or active ranges of motion of the neck. And we're going to begin with rotation side to side, avoiding any movements from a forward head posture. We're keeping it tall, and also making sure that as we rotate the head, we're not looking up or down. It's on a nice swivel. Next, we're going to transition to lateral flexions or lateral bending. We're making sure the movement's coming from the whole neck and not just the top. We're not pushing this range of motion too far, as this can be a little uncomfortable at the base of the neck for those who don't have a neck that moves well. And finally, we're going to tuck the chin and then look up to the sky. Please avoid the whole neck collapsing forward. This is simply a small chin tuck that you should feel in the base of the neck and in the front of the neck. And then we're gently looking up to the sky as well. Here we have shoulder to overhead. We're beginning with the palms facing forward. And finally, reaching the palms together, keeping the elbows straight. Now, the key here is to keep the shoulders in that position with the palms facing forward to avoid any pinching or discomfort in the shoulder itself. And Marie's really reaching for the sky at the top. You may feel a bit of a burn or fatigue in the shoulders. That's okay. You will build those muscles over time. And if you're beginning here, because you have an inability to go all the way overhead, that's okay. As you continue to do this, focus on bringing the arms higher and higher over time. Lumbar lock thoracic rotation. So Marie's gonna be on the ground here in a modified child's pose position. And we're gonna have the knees driven out slightly wider than the hips, and posting the elbow directly in the middle. We're going to take the hand, place it behind the head. Do not allow the head to shift forward and collapse. And breathe out while rotating the thoracic spine, the head and neck, up towards the sky. We're holding for just a second at the top, and we're ensuring that Marie doesn't leave this tunnel. So the torso should not be rotating in its entirety. We want to keep it nice and straight. And of course, we're going to do both sides for this exercise. Now, if this one is too difficult to get into that position, we can utilize a chair. So this is the easier version, but similar principles. We're going to hinge forward a little bit here, and we're going to do the exact same movement pattern with the head in a good position. The torso is rotating, looking up to the sky with a brief pause at the top, nice and controlled. So here we have the chair stretch. The very first thing we're going to do is take the ankle and just drape it across the opposite knee or opposite leg. For some, this is going to be a deep enough stretch as is. And where you're going to feel it is essentially the butt muscle, the hamstring, deep into the hip, and for some, the low back as well, on the side where the foot is on top of the knee. Now, the most common thing that we see here is that people slouch because they feel a lot of tension in this position. However, I really want you to focus on keeping nice, tall posture. And if this is very manageable, think of pulling a string where you basically translate the torso forward, and that's going to deepen that stretch into the hip. So let's say you can master this quite easily. The next progression is going to be doing what's called a pigeon stretch. So Marie's going to similarly have the knee in a bent position, and she's going to effectively be keeping the torso nice and neutral again, and she's sinking into that hip. So you're going to feel this quite deeply into this hip, and you may even feel it through the hip flexor, the front of the leg on the opposite side. And if you can't handle this position, you can do it from the hands. This is a taller position and puts a little bit less pressure through the hips, so you can utilize both options. And of course, we would do both sides for this exercise. Good mornings, a great exercise to open up the hamstrings and engage the core. So we've got our platter of food that we can't spill. Marie's got the core engaged, so the ribs are staying down, shifting the butt back, and then driving the hips forward by squeezing the glutes. So squeezing them at the end there, and really going as deep as possible so that you feel a good lengthening through the back of the leg and the hamstrings. Floor angels. Maria's gonna have the feet directly on the ground here, and we're gonna go to a 90 degree position with the arms on the ground here. Effectively, what Maria is going to do is reach overhead until the elbows straighten, and then she's sliding it back down. Now, for some, this is a difficult movement as you begin to open up the shoulders, so you may only be able to go to here until you start to feel some pressure or too much of a pull, and that's okay. If you get to the top and bringing it back down creates some shoulder dysfunction, you can do a reset instead. So once you get there, just lift up the arms and bring them back in, reset, and then go through your next repetition. So we're gonna finally move into the glute bridge. Marie is on her back again with a nice engaged core. And essentially what's gonna happen is she's gonna think about driving the butt up into the air so that she's in a nice straight line. She's pushing through the heels to maximize the contraction through the butt muscles. And she's holding that for a few seconds and controlling it down. We really want to make sure that this is a straight line and we're not seeing the pelvis move independently of the core. We want to almost see the whole thing function as a unit under control. So we're back with the dead bug progression. Obviously this one more difficult than the level one. We've got the ball, we're in this same position where we're 90 degrees, the arms straight up, and we're maintaining a quality contact between the low back and the floor. Core is nice and engaged. So what happens in this progression is we're gonna begin to move the arms and the legs while maintaining that brace and the contraction against the ball. So the easiest version is to simply start by moving your arms. So we're gonna be maintaining compression on this ball and under control alternating the right and left arm. Let's say you can master that, no problem. Then you're going to only move one leg. This is significantly more difficult than utilizing the arm, so please be aware of that. And you can see it's very nice and controlled, and that contact between the low back and the floor is staying solid. And finally, the most advanced progression of this one will be opposite arm, opposite leg at the same time, maintaining compression against that ball. Perfect. So the second progression of the side bridge is more or less the same as the first, but we're moving from the feet. Now we're going to show one, rather than stack the ankles here, put the top foot just a little bit in front of the bottom. The exact same things apply, where Marie's essentially going to create a nice brace in the core, making sure that the elbow is directly beneath the shoulder, and essentially drive herself into a nice straight line. So she's holding this position, you can see there's a straight line here, the hips aren't sagging down, and she's not rotated forward or back. And she's essentially gonna maintain that position for the allotted time. So we're on to the bird dog again, just a more advanced progression here. Exact same cues, core is engaged, the cup of water is right on top, and we're gonna make sure that we don't spill it. Head is in a nice neutral position and not collapsed forward. So we're going to do the same thing where the opposite arm and opposite leg are moving. However, we're going to fully be engaging the leg this time and lifting it up into the air while maintaining a nice neutral here. So go ahead, Marie, and show us that. So the glute is firing, but we're staying nice and neutral here. The most common thing that will happen as you start to bring the leg up is the pelvis is gonna tip quite dramatically. So we want to make sure that we're keeping that nice and controlled. And you may find that you can't go to full extension there in the leg. You might have to reduce it a little bit to make sure that stays nice and neutral. Best way to know if you're doing this okay, if you don't have a set of eyes, is to videotape yourself doing it and then watch after to see what it looks like.